taking from this creation, taking from this revelation, and they are trying to fit into those things. And they are trying to make it something new, understandable, making it something that we can see and experience it. So these are all the things. So again, my dear friends, here the bottom line is what? What remains forever is what we call the eternal truth. Even simply when you call something truth, that dies no more. That is what we call him. In the first reading, Peter says that it remains forever. What remains forever? Again, my dear friends, is it easy for us to know? It's not that easy for us to know that which remains forever. Yes, that is what we call it, eternal truth. But at the same time, for us humans, it has been revealed to us, but how many of us are capable of knowing it, experiencing it? Again, here is what I find the problem of security. Humans, when it comes to human life, we all are worried about security today. I'm sure in the future, security is going to be a big business for human life. Why? I mean, the way James and John asked Jesus, okay, I don't care whether you are going to Jerusalem, hand it over to men, suffer, and die, rise, whatever you do, where you are going to do, I don't care, but you have to make sure that we sit there on your left and right. So that means what? They wanted to make sure that their place. If you want to put it in our terms, in today's term, it's security. That is what it is. When you say security, what do you actually mean by security? You don't want to die. That's what you mean it. Right? Even there is something that secures my life. What you can secure? Not that which is going to be remain forever. What is going to be remain forever, you won't be able to secure it. If you are going to secure it, protect it, what will happen? You will never know. That's it. You will be ignorant about it. If you are going to protect a seed and keep it in a nice container, keeping it in a locked box forever, what will happen? What will you know? What the seed is capable of? Can you make sure that when you buy a seed, and something that you can give that security, oh, this seed is going to produce a beautiful and a very tasty fruit. Can you give that security? Hey, go on, put it in the ground and see what it can come out. Then taste it and see what it is capable of. Yes. Jesus is telling them, yes, you will do it. You will be baptized. You will be dying for your faith. These things, yes, what you are capable of, yes, Jesus is telling them, yes, you will go through everything. But that security, sitting on your left and right, is not about something that you can know now. believe when you go through, when you die, then when you rise, you will know where you are. That is what it means, dying and rising. And when, unless we die, how will we, how can we know that that is going to remain forever? So as long as we feel like we can be secure and we can be safe, and as long as you protect your life, something, what you are protecting, what you are setting, putting for your safety, it's all about the things that you are going to know more one day. No matter how much you are going to invest, your time, money, anything, whatever that you are going to invest in the name of security and safety, what things that are going to be no more one day, that things that are going to remain forever, there is no security. There is only one way, you have to die and rise. And see what you are in your life. That is not, something that you will know unless you die. The best way is to be ready and know the difference. What is going to be known, what is going to remain forever, that is all we need to be aware of in this life. What is missing in our life in this generation? We have got the education to deal with the things of this world. And there is no education, there is no enough awareness that has been created in our human society that something that we need to be conscious, something that we need to learn, the things that are going to remain forever, for which there is no security, there is no safety, for which you must be ready to die. That is what it means to be a servant. That is what it means to be the last and least of all things. Again, my dear friends, as long as you are going to feed your body and mind, do you think that you will become a servant? That you think that you can consider yourself the last of all? No. As long as you feed your body and mind, you want to sit in the front. You want to be first. You want to be this and that. You want to glorify it, not glorify the truth that is going to remain forever. So again, my dear friends, today I know the whole world is feeding our body and mind and making everyone think great, but we know how long we can stay there. It's not going to be there forever. And of course, before you and me, millions and millions of people have been born and died. Where are they? What are they? Where are we going to be in our life? It's a journey, and we all have to learn it. We are capable of learning it. That is grace. God has given us grace to learn it in our life. Learning means becoming aware, becoming conscious of the things that are going to remain forever. When we are able to stay there, again, my dear friends, there's a beauty, there is joy, there is peace that nothing can take away from us. That is what it means to remain with Jesus. That nothing can separate us from the love of Christ, love of God. Let us continue to remain with Him. As long as we remain with Him, we will bear much fruit. The fruit of joy and peace will remain with us today and all the days of our life here.